Arduino SIM800 GPRS, http://get. Hello friends. Each time we delve deeper into the fascinating applications of the GSM module SIM800. This time, we'll learn how to make HTML GET requests through GPRS communication. I'll demonstrate a simple sketch example with a GET request to a free debugging website. We'll test the standard capabilities of the GPRS module when working with the HTTPS protocol. We'll fetch the precise time from the internet through queries to the corresponding API. Additionally, we'll direct queries to a weather API to find out from global internet data what the current temperature and humidity are outside. Subscribe to my channel right now to not miss out on interesting episodes in the future, and support my efforts with a like. As always, we'll use the combination of Arduino Nano plus SIM800L for convenience in assembly. I've placed them on my shield. It provides a 4.2 volts power supply for the GSM module and also translates the logic signals from 3.3 volts to 5 volts. However, you can assemble it according to your preferences, following this schematic. A more detailed description of the schematic can be found in the first two videos on this topic. The manufacturer's recommendations for setting up HTTP requests with SIM800 are provided in the following PDF file. This is an instruction for various models of GSM microchips. The last update made here was in 2020. However, the firmware of our module was last updated around 2016. Therefore, some of the latest features may not work. Here are recommendations for using GET, POST, and HEAD requests on the HTTP protocol. The guide also describes working with the FTP protocol. To achieve our goals, we'll need the following command sets. Based on the program from the previous video, I've drafted the following lines according to the recommended command sets. The only thing that might differ for you is the APN name of your GPRS operator. Mine is named Internet. In the command HTTP para URL, you need to input the link to a specific website with all the attributes of the GET request. This is where you send the data you want to transmit to the web server. The HTTP action command sends the request and returns the server response code. The HTTP read command returns the server's response in the form of HTML text, JSON, or other formats. Let me show you the first website with which we'll exchange data. It's a simple free test site. Here, in the address bar, we enter two variables, supposedly conveying humidity and temperature values. In response to the request, we receive a text response in the form of a JSON structure, at the beginning of which we see our transmitted variables. This is a very convenient method for debugging HTML requests when working with SIM800. I upload the sketch with this HTTP request to the Arduino Nano controller. I start the port monitor. The AT+SAPBR command returned the IP address of our device on the global internet, indicating that the connection should be operational. HTTP action returned a code of 200, which signifies a successful data exchange with the server. Additionally, the number 331 indicates the size of the server response in bytes. Following the HTTP read command, we receive the content of the response. Here are our test variables with humidity and temperature, as well as the HTTP header data. In the URL parameter, we see the HTTP header. But what if we need to make a request to a site with an HTTPS header, meaning with SSL encryption, which ignores requests without SSL encryption? For this, SIM800 developers have provided several tools, two of the main ones I want to show you. Let's uncomment two lines in the sketch. The HTTPSSL=1 command activates the SSL function, and all requests will be executed with the HTTPS header. If you insert 0, the SSL function will be deactivated. The HTTP para-redir command sets the redirect resolution during requests. This is necessary, for example, for requests to Google macros. I upload the sketch to the Nano. Instead of an IP, we see zeros, meaning the connection hasn't been established yet, and the HTTP action request returned an error code 601. we await the next attempt. We've obtained the IP. Redirect and SSL are activated. The server happily returned a code of 200 and 332 bytes of data. And most importantly, judging by the URL line, we accessed the server via HTTPS, which was exactly what we needed to verify. This way, we've learned how to make HTTP requests to a global debugging internet site using Arduino and SIM800. Now, I suggest practicing fetching internet time using an API. Here's an example of a request in a browser to access the API, which returns a JSON structure with the date and time for a specified region. Now, in the sketch, I'll uncomment this request and update the program on the controller. The SSL function remains active. On the first attempt, we don't receive an IP address and the request isn't sent. On the second attempt, we do get an IP address, but the server throws an error code 606, indicating an SSL issue. Now, I'll comment out the SSL activation and redirect permission, then upload the new program to the controller. On the second attempt, the request processes successfully. We receive a code of 200, and the server sends back the precise date and time. Interestingly, the client IP from the server response doesn't closely match what the GPRS operator supposedly assigned us, but that's not crucial. The main thing is that we've taught our SIM800 to fetch internet time using a web service. Next, I suggest testing the functionality with a weather API. You'll need to register on this site to obtain an access key. I've also predetermined the approximate geographic coordinates of my city. This information is easily searchable for any major populated area on the planet. In the request, you'll need to insert the longitude and latitude coordinates, the access key, and the unit of measurement. I chose the metric system. Let's test this request in the browser. The API returns the air temperature and relative humidity, along with various other meteorological data. Everything matches the coordinates of my city. I'll uncomment the weather request and activate SSL with redirect capabilities. I'll then upload the sketch to the controller. On the first try, we get an IP. That's a good sign. The server returned a code of 200 and 498 bytes of data. Here's the temperature, minus 11 degrees Celsius. Yes, I'm experiencing a real winter chill right now. And here's the relative humidity. It matches what's displayed in the browser. Each of the tested requests, according to the sketch, will activate every 10 seconds. Your task is to continue developing this sketch according to your needs, ensuring the request only runs when necessary. If we gather enough subscriptions and likes, I'll produce a video on how to use the SIM800 to send sensor data to Google spreadsheets and automatically accumulate that data there. Some websites with HTTPS may ignore requests for various reasons. Either the SSL protocol version on the SIM800 might be outdated, or you might need to upload a client certificate file. You can diagnose this issue based on the server response code. If you receive code 605 or 606, it means the server isn't pleased with your SSL-related request. In that case, I recommend reading the PDF titled SIM800 Series SSL Application Note. As you might have noticed, organizing HTTP requests via GPRS is quite straightforward. There may be unsuccessful attempts, but you can diagnose them and retry. With a GET request, you can read data from open APIs or website contents and also send sensor data to your site, receiving control commands and settings from your site into the controller. The program code will always be available on the website. You can globally order shields on Etsy.com. Links are provided below the video. I also welcome your questions in the comments. Wishing you successful experiments and progress. Support my channel, and see you soon.